Many of you guys have asked for an update on the officer from the accidental discharge yesterday. He is still in the hospital, but recovering very well. We do expect him to make a full recovery, and PIU is investigating the incident, okay? So with that, I want to let you guys know that, Aaron, did you start? Okay, perfect. That we're asking for the community's assistance today. Recently, we've had the community come out and provide us tips on several different incidents that we've been able to make arrests on, and this hopefully is no exception. We are going to ask for the community's assistance in this kidnapping, and with that, I'm going to turn it over to Sergeant Matthew Kennington with LMPD's Major Crimes Unit. He's assigned to homicide and missing persons.
Thank you, everyone, for being here. On September 7th, 2021, LMPD was notified of a kidnapping for ransom. According to the victim's family, Jermaine Spruer had been kidnapped from an unknown location. The family received several FaceTime calls from the assailants where they observed Jermaine bound with several guns pointed at him. During the calls, a large sum of money was demanded in exchange for a safe return. The family has since not heard from the assailants, and the victim has not been seen or heard from. We're requesting the community's help to try to locate Mr. Spruer and his vehicle. The victim's vehicle is a blue 2016 Jeep Cherokee with a black carbon fiber hood with a Kentucky license plate of 7171JW, and it also has tinted windows. At the conclusion of this press conference, we'll be providing a photo of the victim with the exact clothing he had on at the last time he was seen, and along with an actual photo of the vehicle for you to use on your newscasts. At this time, we're asking for any assistance from the public in order to bring Mr. Spruer home safely. If you have any information, please contact the homicide unit at 574-7055, or you can call the anonymous tip line at 574-LMPD. With that, I'll open it up for any questions.
Yeah, can you go back to, so you said the family received several FaceTime calls where there were guns pointed at
Yes, sir.
And there was some sort of money exchange. Can you kind of describe that again?
There was not a money exchange. The assailants demanded money, a large sum of money from the family for his safe return.
At this time, do you happen to know how much money that was?
I do not. I'm sorry.
And after those calls, they have since not had any communication with that person?
They have not, no.
Did they agree to pay him in that call or make any kind of arrangements?
I don't know at this time. I'm sorry.
Were those phone numbers traceable at all or recognizable by?
They believe they used the victim's phone. So all the calls came from the victim's phone.
Did any of the family members say that the voice of the assailant or assailants sound familiar, or do we know how many were involved?
I didn't see the phone calls, so I don't know the exact details of how many people were in there. And to their knowledge, from what I understand, that we don't have any idea of who took Mr. Spruer.
Thank you guys. And we do appreciate you guys coming out for this, you know, and there are some details that are still a little bit sensitive since obviously he may still be held by his captors. So thank you guys so much for helping us on this, and we hope somebody out there has some information that they can provide. And as Sergeant Kennington said, you can call the anonymous tip line at 574-LMPD. Certainly if you see him or see anyone you believe involved in this, call 911 immediately.
Do you have any information about where this occurred so people might know if they saw something in such and such a location?
Well, he was last seen in the 6100 block of Crockett Drive was when he was last physically seen.
Just a question, I mean, are kidnapping for ransom, is that some sort of common thing that LMPD deals with? I mean, how unique is this sort of situation?
Kidnapping for ransoms are pretty rare. That's certainly why we have you guys here today, because we don't have these that frequently, and it's something that we obviously are taking very seriously and want the community to come out and help us. If you see anything, please give us a call on the anonymous tip line, or if you actually see Mr. Spruer or anyone that is believed to be involved in it, call 911 immediately. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.